I'm so happy. Yes, I am so happy that Nova Stevens won. I think it's so great. She's so amazing, so fantastic. She has a great story to tell. I'm so happy, especially with the organization that it is, that she was able to get there and that they let her get there. I think it's awesome. Awesome. Congrats, girl. So I'm really happy. I will get more into Nova and just the amazingness that she is. But I do wanna do my final review. I did actually record this right after the streaming debacle, but I re-recorded it because I know that they did the streaming a few days ago. I wasn't able to watch the full thing because I was busy, but I have seen some clips since then here and there. So I thought I would just do a quick kind of final review of the Miss Universe Canada 2020. So yes, where should we start? From the top. Okay, so I'm just gonna say a little bit about the whole streaming thing. I'm not gonna harp on it or talk too much about it because I think everybody is all in the same place in terms of how they feel about it. But I did think that there were some production glitches a little bit. I thought production could be a little bit better, but we are in a pandemic. It's COVID. There's people that aren't working. There's, you know, everybody's trying to figure out this whole streaming thing that they haven't maybe done in the past. So it is what it is. I will say, I just kind of wish that they just announced the winners. Just announce her so we can all move on with our lives. I was waiting for so long. I mean, the wait was worthwhile, of course, but I don't know. I wonder if we still go through COVID for, you know, a long, long time. Knock on wood. I just think that maybe a nice, beautiful presentation or like a plan B, like, of course you can do the whole pageant thing, sure. But then maybe a really beautiful presentation similar to like Miss Puerto Rico. I just love that where it's just like, she's just, you know, there in all of her beauty and glory. And then it's just like, here you go. Here's our winner. And maybe like the runner ups are behind or something like that as like, you know, she wins, she gets a crown. Beautiful, whatever, and then, you know, all the girls hug her, blah, 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 they go away, and then it's just, like, a nice, beautiful presentation, so that maybe if situations come like that again, maybe that's what they show up. I don't know. Again, I'm just in marketing and events, so I think about these things, but in terms of the stage, I actually thought the stage looked really nice straight on, but I did think that it was pretty obvious that it was in a banquet hall, which that's fine. I think a banquet hall is fine. I just thought when the camera turned, you can see like the planters and the carpet. I just wish that they put something on the sides, like, I don't know, some like lights or screens or floral or anything to kind of like make it more like a set. But I thought that the stage itself in terms of like straight on, I thought it was fine. Yeah, and then you can see like people walking on the sides too, so that was a little bummer. I thought there were some issues with the sound, but again, like we're all just trying to figure out this new world that is COVID-19. So yeah, so it is what it is in that situation. I did think that the beginning with all of the costumes, great idea. Obviously we're showing national pride, great. I just thought it was a little awkward. Like, I was very uncomfortable. So I couldn't imagine how some of the girls feel. Like, for me, that would have been bomb because I love to dance. But I just felt like some of the girls are a little awkward and uncomfortable. I get the reason behind it. I also thought that it was really obvious what was professional costumes and what wasn't. So, and of course, like, I mean, bravo to all the ladies that were able to pull something together, because, you know, because that's unreal. But I there was a little inconsistency for me. Like, there were some girls that weren't even in costumes, just like a dress. So I just wish there was a little bit of cohesiveness at the beginning. And if, you know, there isn't a standard, then maybe all the girls should have just been in red and white, or just red or white. I don't know. That's just my two cents. But hey, what do I know? And then, yeah, it was a little bit, to me, it was more on the Caribbean side. I loved the music. I thought the music was awesome. I really enjoyed it. But, and I do think it does show a little bit of Canadian multiculturalism for sure. I just, to me, it felt a little bit like more of a Miss Trinidad and Tobago pageant at the beginning. It was a little different. But again, I see where they're going with it. I did really like seeing some of the past winners, like Leanne Cecile, who I love. That was actually the first Miss Canada pageant that I really saw, right? Because before then, there wasn't really any sort of videos or anything like that. So definitely a fan of Leanne. Actually, she judged my pageant when I was at Miss Universe Canada 2012. So she's lovely. And then Natalie Glebova. So that was kind of cool too. I think that Nova got trained by Natalie, which totally makes sense. I liked seeing who the judges were. I liked that they walked up and you can actually see who they were. I liked that it was a smaller panel. Like, typically, I think that they have like tons of judges, like 10 or 11 or something like that. So yeah, I liked that too. What else did I like about the pageant? The top 20. I loved a lot of the top 20. It was kind of cool. I wish that there was a preliminary, because some of the girls in the top 20, I was so pleasantly surprised. I was like, wow, like, I don't remember her name, but the girl that said like spicy, I just was like, oh, she's so cute. And all of them, they all had, you know, something very, very special about them. Yeah, I really, really liked the top 20. I thought it was a really good call. Mira, my girl, she made it. She looked great. And then all of the, you know, usual favorites. So I thought the top 20 was really, really good. Top 10 made sense from what I saw. Like, all of them. And then for the top 5, I knew it. I called that. No, just watching the small clips and reading their bios and the photos, for me, it was a no-brainer, 100%. And as I said before in my other video, it was interchangeable. Like, any of those girls could have really won. It's really dependent on so many different factors, like the day, the question, like how you feel, the judges. And so, so I'm really happy with the top 5. Of course, I'd love to see some of the girls there, like Mamira. But yeah, I for sure, it was no-brainer for me. Okay, I thought Alyssa looked so beautiful. Like, that pantsuit. Somebody's got to show me or tell me where to get that pantsuit, because that pantsuit was amazing. She looked so amazing in it. I want it. Not that I have anywhere to wear it to, but she looked so beautiful. It was a bummer because the clip that I saw, like the when they released the first half of the pageant, when she was talking, I saw Sunny and Chelsea. Hi, Chels. Hi, Sunny. You guys look great. But it was a bummer. I kind of really wanted to bask in all her glory, but she looked really, really good. Since then, I did see her her walk when she did her final walk, and I thought that dress, and she also looked super beautiful there. I think she should have wore that dress at Miss Universe. I thought just it was awesome. It was just so gorgeous. It's totally my style. If I had a choice of what I could wear at Miss Universe, for sure I would have something like that. Love it. I saw clips of Nova talking, and I think I heard like a wow in the background somewhere. She's just such a powerful speaker. And in this time where there's so much hatred and division, I thought it was such a powerful statement that she, you know, brought to the table. And I think sometimes when you are of a minority, you sometimes feel scared to bring that up because you don't, you know, want it to be the only thing that it's about in terms of race. But I think she did it eloquently, beautifully. And not only that, I think she's going to be a role model for a lot of young people, especially a lot of young people with dark skin. and, you know, are immigrants and maybe don't look like the norm, you know, beauty. I think she did a beautiful job. Her dress with that cape, girl, stunning, stunning, beautiful. I thought all the dresses were beautiful, but man, she just commanded that stage, and I thought that it was gorgeous. And to see another African on the Miss Universe stage representing Canada, like, I cannot be more happy. I think it's well deserved, and I think it's about time. And so let's just, you know, support her. I know I will be, and I can't wait to see her journey, because it's gonna be great, I'm sure. In general, I'm happy with the results. I really am. I think Jamie has many years. She's young to compete again, and same with the other girls. So yeah, I hope that, you know, by me sharing my story and her sharing her stories, that it just keeps the ball rolling. And I think she's gonna do awesome at Miss Universe. I honestly think she will. I think she's right up there. I haven't seen all the contestants, but she's definitely up there for sure. And she has a great story to tell, and she means it, and she speaks it, and she walks it. So big congratulations to Nova. I wish you all the best. I'm definitely going to be watching your journey, and congrats again, and good luck in your reign. So that's it from me. Please message below in terms of any sort of anything else that you want me to chat about. This is not just going to be a pageant vlog, so I'm open to suggestions. Again, I'm here just to share my life and experience with all of y'all. Again, thank you so much for your support. Subscribe, like, and keep following this journey. All right, talk to you soon. Bye.